2 months ago, a young man named Hiro Mikishiba went missing during his stint as a student teacher. Mikishiba quickly becomes the center of attention when his rotting corpse is discovered, and Yagami scours the school for any clues left behind. Rumor has it, Mikishiba drove a classmate to suicide in his student days. A rumor that the school faculty is seemingly unable to deny.
Troisième chapitre, une question de perspective. Alors, cet article parle peut-être de Mikoshi, mais il n'y a aucune information sur l'identité du cadavre. C'est-à-dire que la police n'a pas dit tout ce qu'elle savait. L'interrogatoire de Madame Sawa prend vraiment beaucoup de temps.
Yagami-san, why are you still here?
Because I care. Now, if you're open to the idea, you think we could walk and talk?
Why? So you can grill me with more questions? You realize the police just finished doing that, yes?
I figured they'd come knocking sooner or later.
Then you knew Mikishiba-kun was murdered, didn't you? And that's why you've been snooping around our school.
You're not wrong, but can we please take this elsewhere?
If you knew Mikishiba was murdered, why didn't you tell me up front?
J'avais pas le droit.
Because that information's not public. Didn't the police ask you to keep quiet about it?
Well, yes, but even so.
What sort of questions were they asking you anyway?
I thought I was supposed to keep quiet.
Cute.
Now I'm going to ask you one last time. Please, stay off our campus. You don't belong here.
C'est bizarre,
I mean,
sa réaction.
What if you end up injuring a student? It would be a nightmare for all of us.
Nobody's getting injured. All that's water under the bridge now.
Is that so?
Yeah, and I should probably mention, I'm the new advisor of the Mystery Research Club. I have the chairman's approval and everything. So, it looks like I have a place here after all.
What? Since when?
I think we're getting sidetracked here. Did the police ever mention a suspect?
No. All they told me was what happened to Mikishiba-kun. That he's no longer a missing person. That he's dead. And was dumped in a derelict building.
My condolences.
That was all we found out. The police were the ones asking the questions, not us. They hardly gave us room to breathe.
Yeah, sounds like an interrogation, all right.
La police a-t-elle l'intention de garder le rôle Terra secret le temps de l'enquête?
Is there anything else?
Actually, there is. I'd like to know your thoughts on Mikishiba-kun's killer.
What?
For example, take Akihiro Ehara, a man who took this school to court over his son's suicide. Mikishiba came up even then, as a culprit bearing some responsibility for that.
Ehara-san? But he got arrested for that groping incident at the train station.
So the police really are keeping their lips sealed.
Must you always be so cryptic?
It's possible Ehara-san had a hand in Mikishiba's murder.
What?
Despite being incarcerated for 2 months, he knew exactly where the corpse would be. He revealed it upon being sentenced. This was before the Kanagawa police had even ID'd the body.
Then... was it really Ehara-san?
A court would say being in jail is about as solid an alibi as you can get. But he could be connected somehow.
How do you know all this, Yagami-san?
Je suis très fort.
I tell you, but I showed you one of my cards, so now it's your turn.
Huh?
I've heard you weren't as big a fan of Mikoshiba as you led me to believe. That true?
This again.
You knew he was a bully all along, but yesterday you told me he wasn't the type. I just want to get the story straight here. Did you have a sudden change of heart, or were you lying to me for some reason?
It's not that simple.
Oh, one more thing I learned today. It was Mikoshiba who turned the basketball club against Koda-san. Pretty sadistic for a would-be teacher, don't you think?
That's enough.
Then it's not a stretch to say he probably was a major factor in the death of Ehara-san 4 years ago? And I think it's also safe to assume you know more than you're letting on, right? This is murder we're talking about here. Lies aren't doing anyone any favors.
His name was Toshiro.
Sorry?
Everyone keeps saying Ehara-san, like he's just another statistic. He had a name, for heaven's sake. Toshiro.
Right. I'm sorry.
Now, if you'll excuse me, I have papers to grade.
Zawa-sensei, please!
9 o'clock tonight. I'll be at Plage on Izazaki Road.
We'll finally have a real talk?
Something like that.
Kaito-san, so I just left the school, and tonight I'm... Wait, where are you?
Third stop of our bar crawl, that's where. I thought work was done for the night.
Licking the wounds of rejection, huh? Is the 99 gang with you?
Just Sugiura. Tsukumo said he had to get back to the office to take care of some kind of system trouble.
A computer crash or something?
Don't know. Something about a buzzy searcher going haywire. I've pretty much tuned it out, man. Anyway, you gonna come take his place?
Nah, I gotta stay sober. I'm meeting Sawa-sensei in a bit.
You what? God damn it, man, you are killing me today!
Would you simmer down? This is work, not whatever it is you're doing.
Oh, then I ought to come be your backup. Where are we headed?
Come on, you think I need a drunk co-pilot? Knock one back for me, though.
Hey. I better not find out you two got it on. Don't do this to me, Toc.
Alors, il me reste encore du temps avant l'heure du rendez-vous, je pourrais passer voir Tsukumo.
Yagamishi, how was school? Kaito-san wasn't happy about you going solo, you know.
Eh, he'll live. He can cry about it to Sugiura.
So he does. Anyway, I couldn't help but notice Skenda Law bending your ear earlier. Anything important?
Right. I haven't filled you in yet, have I?
So a policeman arrested for sexual battery might have actually been involved in a murder? Fascinating. if not perplexing.
Yeah, and its roots could very well be Serio High School, where a student was driven to suicide 4 years ago. In fact, the motive for this murder may even be revenge. Tsukumo, could you find any mention of that suicide online for me?
Already done, I'm afraid. Once the chairman asked us to take his case, I looked into everything on the school I could find. If memory serves, he was a third-year student who hung himself at home. The name of the deceased, Toshiro Ehara.
Yeah, that's him.
So, while I did find some murmurings about it online, nothing really substantial ever surfaced. He didn't leave a suicide note or a will, and investigators never found anything salient.
So I was right before.
Ça ne fait aucun doute, c'est bien le même garçon que sur la photo.
His father, however, suspected there may have been a bully and promptly took Serio to court. But without enough evidence to back it up, the system more or less spit him out. Even so, the lawsuit dragged on until this year. But that level of news hardly makes a ripple online.
Yeah, I doubt it would.
And that's all the intel I've dug up regarding the case. Huh?
What's that sound?
I'm testing a system I've been tinkering with. Thought I'd fixed this bug already.
A system for what?
Well, it predicts the occurrence of crimes.
It predicts crime? No way.
Perhaps that was a bit of hyperbole. Essentially, this system is designed to monitor and detect danger zones within a specific area. The city itself, to be exact.
That still sounds pretty amazing.
If you say so. I basically cobbled it together out of pre-existing tech. Yagamishi, do you remember when I used my chatter search program for you not too long ago?
Oh yeah, that was a real trip. You pretty much hacked chatter to see an entire social network at a glance.
Yep, and this system I've developed is a souped-up version of that. Though there are substantial differences, the principle is still... how about you just try it out? We'll start with this little window. It displays all relevant chatter posts after filtering the fluff.
And these posts are all pinpointed on this map of Ijincho?
Right. It maps out where in Ijincho each specific post was made. So my AI constantly combs through chatter's database as it updates in real time. Then it extracts only the trouble-related chatter for display on the map.
So it actively seeks out trouble? It's wild that you can program around such a vague concept.
Well, in its current iteration, the AI isn't exactly genius material yet, so it still pings some false positives.
There's something else, Tsukumo. What are you gonna use it for?
I'd like to use it for promotional purposes.
Like advertising?
Yeah, since we're still relatively new in town, we don't have the kind of rep that brings in regular business.
Okay.
And that is where my buzz researcher comes into play.
Buzz researcher?
Consider the glut of trends and terms strewn across social media. These buzzwords are sometimes clues to trouble beneath the surface. So, when the system picks up one of these words and we rush over to save the day, the hope is our reputation will flourish as a result.
Damn, that's some pretty intense marketing you've got going.
Well, we probably won't be paid for impromptu cases, so this is sort of an upfront investment. But directly intervening before a situation gets out of hand will build us the brand we want. At least in theory. I'm not sure how it'll all pan out yet.
Well, I think you've got something there, Tsukumo. Mind if I give it a shot?
I thought you'd never ask. Though the system's got a long way to go by my standards. But with you as a tester, I know I'll get strong enough feedback to have this baby running in top form.
So you wanted me as your guinea pig all along.
You sure cracked that case quick. Anywho, let me get this app booted up on your phone. May I do the honors?
Go right ahead.
And that should do it. Here you are.
Okay, let's see here. This is just a big mess. How am I supposed to know where to go?
This is indeed too much noise. In fact, this is entropy in motion. This won't do at all. To solve this, we narrow down the keywords.
In other words, simplify our search?
Yeah, by manually filtering keywords, we can decrease false positives, thereby locating the right spot more accurately.
How do we do that? Does the AI do it for us?
No, not entirely. What the AI does is pick up on any keywords it deems important. Emphasis here on the word any. Meaning it'll turn out duds every now and again.
Yeah, that's still pretty busy.
And therein lies the predicament. To narrow these results down any further, we must depend on instincts, experience, and even inspiration.
So you're saying human intuition?
Precisely. Even in this day and age, human intuition will trump AI every time. That is, until we all become cyborgs. But that's getting ahead of myself. As it stands, Yagamishi, you've got the best intuition out of all of us.
Well, let's just start with a post that smells like trouble. How about this one? I could smell the trouble brewing already.
Oh, interesting. Then let's filter our results around that specific term. And there you have it. See, there's a concentration of suspicious keyword usage on this street here. As to what sort of trouble is brewing, you'll have to rely on your good old-fashioned eyeballs. Shady activity isn't always the easiest to spot, so maybe think of it as a sort of treasure hunt.
A treasure hunt for trouble, huh? Does sound right up my alley.
Doesn't it? I can already picture you out there, helping people in need until it all pays off. What could await you at the end of the trail? My heart rate is already spiking.
I'm just glad to have a helpful app for once.
You know what? That reminds me. I also have a gadget here you may find useful. Can't always be glued to your phone, right?
What is this?
It's a high-end sound collector. It boosts the volume of mid-distance sounds, making them easier to hear from farther away.
A sound collector, huh? I could use this to pick up cries for help, or even eavesdrop all over town.
That's the idea. With enhanced hearing and geolocation capabilities, you'll be a trouble terminator.
Just like I've always wanted.
Now, I do have some other gadgets in the works, but I'm still fine-tuning their UI. I'll show you soon enough.
Looking forward to that.
Information précieuse, les objets de valeur sont essentiels pour progresser dans l'histoire ou utiliser certains services. Vous pouvez consulter les objets dans l'inventaire. Contrairement à d'autres objets, les objets de valeur ne peuvent être ni vendus ni jetés. Utiliser des gadgets pour trouver l'arachnide. Elle nous donne un point de chute. Alors, ceux qui affirment avoir entendu des grognements disent les avoir entendus par ici, je crois. Doit découvrir ce que ces grognements. Ce qu'on sont ces grognements. Tuer le gadget. On va se le reprendre parce qu'il a pas l'air de vouloir le sortir, notre ami. Voilà.
There it is.
Je tombe. Tomber, ça venait d'au-dessus. C'est quoi ce délire? C'est une personne. Je vais tomber, je n'arrive pas à tenir. Oh non. Faut que je l'aide tout de suite. Faire secondaire, l'homme suspendu dans le vide. Il veut pas grimper, c'est... Ouais, c'est pas X, c'est... On a perdu un peu de temps. Alors pourquoi il veut pas voilà. Je trouve que les commandes réagissent mal, c'est assez hallucinant, je trouve. C'est dommage, parce que ces phases sont sympas, mais elles sont frustrantes. On a l'impression des fois que ne peut pas grimper le bonhomme.
Excuse moi.
Il ne peut plus tenir. Putain, mais qu'est-ce qu'il fout là? Qui êtes-vous? Je vous ai vu d'en bas, je suis venu vous aider. Je suis sauvé, j'ignore comment ma main a glissé. Merci infiniment. C'est quoi ce raffut? Ah, que faites-vous? Vous habitez ici, vous pourriez appeler à l'aide s'il vous plaît? Ne dites pas que vous êtes l'arachnide, attendez, il y en a deux. Oh non, je vais tomber. C'est assez dangereux. Alors, c'est hallucinant, mais il va se casser la gueule et ils vont se taper une discussion de 15 minutes. Est-ce qu'on pourrait rentrer à l'intérieur? Oui, bien sûr. Alors, c'est pas passé loin. Merci de nous avoir laissé entrer, madame. C'est quoi cette histoire? Qu'est-ce que vous faisiez là-haut tous les deux? Je suis Yagami, détective. Yeah. Vous êtes détective, oui. Vous voyez, je me promenais quand j'ai vu cette personne sur le point de tomber. Pardon de vous avoir dérangé, mon nom est Tamae Shinataro. Oui, ouais, bon, ok. Qu'est-ce que vous faisiez là? C'est parce que, à vrai dire, j'observais les oiseaux sur le toit et j'ai fait un mauvais pas. Mon cul, c'est un mensonge. Oui, parce que j'ai entendu dire qu'il y avait un oiseau rare dans le coin. Un oiseau rare, hein. Quelle espèce? Une hirondelle. Vous pensez que les hirondelles sont des oiseaux ordinaires? Eh bien, celle-ci est toute blanche à cause d'une mutation. Quelqu'un en a parlé sur les réseaux sociaux, alors j'ai foncé ici. L'arachnide aime observer les oiseaux, ça me paraît un peu louche. Alors, vous habitez dans cet immeuble, vous n'avez pas pensé à demander à l'aide? Ce n'est pourtant pas la saison. Alors, c'était des oiseaux migrateurs, elles devraient être ailleurs en ce moment, pour passer l'hiver. Bon, je me base sur ce que je lis sur internet, mais les hirondelles qui passent l'hiver au Japon restent normalement dans les régions de l'Ouest. Ce serait assez inhabituel d'en voir ici dans la région de Kanto. Oui, exactement, elles sont très rares ici, c'est pour ça que je voulais en voir une. Ok, je vois. Pas pensé à demander de l'aide. Oui, j'imagine que j'aurais pu, ça ne m'a pas effleuré. Très suspect même, bon. Vous n'habitez pas dans cet immeuble, n'est-ce pas? Vous avez dit à l'instant que vous avez accouru après avoir lu sur les réseaux sociaux que l'hirondelle serait là. Très impressionnant, monsieur le détective, vous êtes malin, dites donc. Ce bâtiment est fermé aux personnes de l'extérieur. Comment êtes-vous rentré? Eh bien, c'est... En plus, la porte qui mène au toit est verrouillée la plupart du temps et pourtant, vous avez réussi à accéder. C'est que je fais comme vous, monsieur. J'ai escaladé le mur. J'ai escaladé. Oui, je les aime tellement, vous comprenez. Donc, cet arachnide dont tout le monde parle, c'est vous? Oui. Il a l'air d'avoir beaucoup de rumeurs à ce sujet. Tout ce que je veux, c'est observer les oiseaux depuis la hauteur, mais aucun bâtiment n'autorise les non-résidents à entrer dans cette ville. C'est la raison pour laquelle j'ai commencé à escalader les murs. L'arachnide n'est donc qu'amoureux des oiseaux. Mais quand même, tout cela n'a pas beaucoup de sens, c'est suspect. Mais même si c'est louche, je n'ai aucune preuve. Et sans preuve, je dois lâcher l'affaire, mais dans ces moments-là, il suffit parfois de savoir observer. C'est bizarre, elle a pas dit qu'il y avait deux arachnides observés attentivement. Alors attends. Ah.
Suspicious. What the...
Une petite culotte, ah ouais d'accord, ok. Qu'est-ce que c'est? D'après la forme, je dirais que c'est une culotte. Bon, bah voilà. C'est un pervers. Est-ce que je peux vous demander quelque chose? Ouais, il y a autre chose. Qu'est-ce que vous avez dans votre poche?
This is...
C'est une culotte. Berk, c'est... Est-ce qu'elle serait à vous? Je me disais bien que certaines de mes culottes préférées avaient disparu. En réalité, vous êtes tombé en tentant de voler une culotte. J'appelle la police, pas si vite, d'ailleurs. Je suis en phase de devenir le prochain professeur culotte. Oh non, je ne me laisserai pas attraper par quelqu'un de votre genre. Très bien, alors je n'ai pas le choix, je vais devoir utiliser la force. Et un pervers en moins, un. Bon sang et dire que j'allais devenir le prochain professeur culotte. Je le connais bien, vous savez, c'est même moi qui l'ai attrapé. Même une fois commencé, ce pervers n'a pas essayé de cacher sa vraie nature. Il a été fier, il a brandi une culotte devant moi, il m'a demandé si je voulais prendre part au banquet. Oh là là. Il a été courageux jusqu'au bout. Pour être honnête, vous n'arrivez pas à la cheville du professeur culotte, vous ne serez jamais au même niveau. Allez, on y va, ouais, ça suffit, connerie. Embarquez-moi ça. Merci.
Non.
Pas de problème. Alors, vous avez dit que vous étiez détective, n'est-ce pas? Ouais, d'habitude, je travaille aux alentours de Kamurocho, mais j'ai commencé à travailler ici. N'hésitez pas à me contacter si vous avez un problème. Vous aidez les gens tout en faisant la promotion de votre agence, c'est très astucieux. Je n'y manquerai pas la prochaine fois que je croiserai quelqu'un dans le besoin, je leur dirai de vous contacter. Ben nickel, ça a marché. Une affaire de plus. Alors, tester en ville le nouveau gadget. Ça c'est fait, on va retourner à l'agence.
Yagamishi, how was your first outing?
Not bad. I handled the problem and name-dropped you guys, so all in a day's work.
Awesome. Sounds like the system's working gangbusters. By the way, if you'd like a little pro tip, you can enter keywords on your own, independent of any post.
Why would I do that?
Say you pick up a rumor in town, or hear someone drop a dubious phrase. Putting that into our keyword database will help refine the results algorithm. And thus, the program becomes more effective. In layman's terms, the more you enter new data, the more my program can learn.
Gotcha. So this thing can hone its street smarts along with me.
Correct. Do make use of the system often, if you could. I know this is a lot, but one last thing. We've also got a bulletin board for case requests. A good number of them are somewhat beyond our current capacity. So if you ever feel like it, maybe you can pick them up.
Hey, never hurts to have more income. I'll take a look sometime.
problem.
Stereo High School, class 2-2. Yes? Sir?
Take your breath! You guys don't say much, do you? After this is over, you better start talking. Time to tell me what you know! Keep going.
Yo! Need a hand with these guys?
Huh?
Good job holding them back on your own.
Dude!
You're not the only hero here.
Where did you even come from?
I was watching from inside, man.
Okay. You shouldn't get involved.
Relax, fella. Allow me to show you how it's done.
Hold on!
Listen up. I'm just gonna warn you, I'm a better fighter than this guy.
Huh? Fuck.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Right. Thanks for making them slink into the night before I could even ask who they were.
Huh?
Later.
Can I help you?
I came here to meet someone. I'll just check upstairs real quick. Sensei. Are you okay? Did someone get here before me?
I'm sorry. There's nothing I can say. I can't tell you anything you don't already know.
What happened up here? Did someone come to intimidate you? Someone who might be involved?
I couldn't make out who the woman was. She had sunglasses on.
What did she say to you?
need to stay away from this. The whole Mikoshiba-kun case. And then she said that you need to do the same.
Me too?
Yes.
And what if I were to refuse?
If you said no, then she told me I should give you this picture.
Huh? This is Mikoshiba.
I'm so sorry, but I'm leaving.
Wait! I get it. At least let me walk you home.
Just stop! I don't want anything to do with this! If you come back to the school, I'd appreciate it if you would stop talking to me. There's nothing I can do to help you anymore. What the? Hey. Suspicious. Hey. Still so many unanswered questions.
That would be the white mask of the Yokohama Liomon. These guys would break your knees for the right price.
So they're just a bunch of thugs for hire?
Pretty much.
Well, anything else I can do for you?
I've earned something of a reputation here in this town. But you've got a face I haven't seen anywhere before. Why are these goons picking a fight with you? Got any ideas?
I've got a hunch. But I'm gonna keep it to myself.
A tightwad, huh? Didn't I just bail your ass out?
A handyman?
It's Kuwana. You got trouble here, I'm the one you call. I'm not afraid to get my hands dirty. I can handle shit the cops won't deal with either.
Not exactly a service I'm in need of at the moment. Crossing that line is tough. And I prefer to do it myself.
Oh, really? And what line of work would that be?
I'm a private detective in Kamurocho. What is it now?
Some competition just showed up on my turf and made a scene, man. How would you feel if the situation was reversed? You wouldn't tolerate any disrespect, would you? So state your name, and then you say, "Sorry, Kuwana, I made a bit of a ruckus here."
Exactly how high up the food chain is a handyman in this town?
A I'm just trying to teach you some manners.
People let you teach manners around here? You can't even exchange cards right.
I see you know how to block a kick. So let's move on to the next part. Don't let me down now. That's fancy. How's this? Hey, what else you got? Better than I was expecting.
Right back at you. Give yourself a pat on the back.
Hey, you want to tone it down, or you want another lesson?
I'm listening.
You don't know when to give up.
Time's up, both of you. The cops are almost here.
Sugiura-kun.
You know each other?
After we get out of here. Come on, let's use the back way. Seriously? How do a couple of grown-ass men end up bickering like that?
I was just finishing what he started.
Yeah. And you can thank Sugiura-kun here that you're still standing.
How do you even know this guy?
Kawana-san's our senpai here in Ijincho. He's the local handyman. He's got tons of connections both above and below ground. So, definitely a higher tier of service than us.
Have you been working together?
No, but we did pay our respects before we opened our office. Bowed our heads, asked for his blessing, all that.
Unlike someone, Sugiura-kun knows his manners.
Settle down. So talk, who were those idiots back there?
Kawana-san says they're a gang. Yokohama Liumang.
Specifically, Liumang assassins, called the White Masks. They were surprisingly inept back there, though.
Nah, they just didn't know who they crossed.
Hold up, assassins? Why would someone put a hit out on Yagni-san?
Maybe they were just out to scare you. I mean, I doubt even the Liumang would take someone out in public. They don't like crowds.
Whatever the case, can you find out who hired them? I prefer to know who wants me dead.
No can do. Even they don't know their clients. They get all their gigs piped in from the dark web. Good news is, you can hire them yourself, too. Want me to hit them up for you?
No thanks. I'm good on the contract killing front.
Man, oh man. What kind of shit did you step in? If you're gonna make a mess in this town, I want in. Some things are better left to the locals. Especially when it starts turning gray.
Fine by me.
What is?
Having someone around who knows the ins and outs of Ijincho, man. Besides, don't you owe him for saving your ass from the White Masks?
He didn't save my ass.
Hold a stick out, buddy. I can tell he's cool. Yo, wanna grab a drink? On me.
Now here's a kindred spirit. You're on, but I'm getting round two.
See? I knew you weren't half bad.
Wait, show me now, do you?
You coming with, Tuck?
Nah, not tonight. I'm heading back to the agency. Got a few things to sort out.
Your loss. As they say, always take what comes, never chase what leaves.
My thoughts exactly. Except, maybe a little more fancy.
It's like we're already old friends.
Hey. Gotcha.
véhiculé, je vais m'assurer qu'il ne vous cause pas de problème. C'est dans les objets. La défoncer. Hein. Merci Yagami, vous m'avez sauvé la mise, comme au bon vieux temps. Au fait, qu'est-ce qui vous amène à Lincho? Vous avez quitté Kamurocho pour de bon? Eh bien, disons que je me suis lancé dans une quête à la découverte de moi-même. Lors de notre première rencontre, je vous ai raconté que j'avais été abandonné dans les montagnes quand j'étais enfant, si je ne me trompe pas. Ouais. Quand on vous a retrouvé, vous avez déjà une recette d'extrait sur vous. Exactement, comme je n'ai aucune famille, ce vieux document est le seul indice de mon passé. Quoi, j'ai consacré ma vie à l'étudier pour tenter de découvrir d'où je viens. D'ailleurs, vous pensiez que vos parents étaient peut-être des Tengu, non? Je ne sais pas si vous étiez sérieux, mais vous avez du nouveau là-dessus? Malheureusement non, mais je crois qu'on peut me guider vers la réponse. Qu'est-ce qui vous fait dire ça? J'ai entendu parler d'un chercheur qui vit ici. Il se trouve qu'il possède un codex ancien très similaire à la recette de l'extrait. Je vois. Vous pensez que c'est une piste? Oui, c'est la raison de ma venue ici. Et comme j'en aurai pour un moment, j'ai décidé d'ouvrir boutique. Et là, ça a vite attiré l'attention de cette brute. Eh bien, vos extraits sont vraiment uniques en leur genre. Ce n'était qu'une question de temps avant que quelqu'un essaie d'en tirer profit. Et vous imaginez, si je les produisais en masse, ils pourraient tomber entre les mains de vrais criminels. Vous avez parfaitement raison. Quoi qu'il en soit, vous devriez passer à la boutique, un de ces quatre. Elle est à Chinatown. J'ai développé de nouveaux extraits depuis votre dernière visite.
Yep.
Je suis pas un peu fier. Ah bon? Eh bien, je serais ravi de faire ça tout de suite. Avec plaisir, suivez-moi. Ah, ça a l'air dégueulasse. C'est donc ici. Je suppose que cette déco l'aide à chantir chez lui. Faites comme chez vous. Ouais. Je me souviens bien du poisson dégueulasse qui bouillit. Sa nouvelle boutique sent aussi mauvais que l'ancienne. Bon, vous vous rappelez comment on fabrique les extraits, n'est-ce pas, hein? Honnêtement, j'ai presque tout oublié. Ça fait déjà quelques années. Ne vous en faites pas, on va reprendre depuis le début. Un extrait concentre l'essence pure de la nature. Il en existe plusieurs sortes et tous ont un effet particulier. Certains restaurent la santé, d'autres amplifient des aptitudes spécifiques et certains réduisent même les risques de confrontation. Vous voulez dire qu'il me suffirait d'en boire pour éviter les bagarres? Vous croyez que c'est possible, scientifiquement parlant? Dit comme ça, il est vrai que le principe semble mystérieux, mais je pense qu'il produit un phénomène qui inhibe l'agressivité de certaines personnes. Un spray anti-lascar en somme quoi. Bref, pour préparer un extrait, il faut tout d'abord réunir quelques matériaux. Pour vous remercier de m'avoir aidé, je vais vous en offrir. Récipient extrait, ouais. Aile de dragon. Pyroxène arc-en-ciel. Bois sacré. Décomposition sacrée. Ça, c'est un plat préparé, ok. J'espère juste que ça ne va pas me péter à la gueule. Ah ouais, ça met tout ce que j'ai besoin. Un récipient et du dragon. On va pouvoir en refabriquer un. Hein. Ok, bon, je crois que j'ai fini. Beau travail, ce n'était pas difficile, pas vrai. Il vous suffit de trouver les bons matériaux en ville et les ajouter au bouillon et votre extrait sera prêt en rien de temps. Pour vous éviter de repasser me voir à chaque fois, voici une gourde avec ma solution spéciale à l'intérieur. Comme ça, vous pourrez concocter des extraits où que vous soyez. Ça, c'est bien ça. Il faut l'extrait préparé. Il vous faudra un récipient à extrait vide pour le conserver. Vous ne pouvez mettre qu'un extrait par récipient. C'est la règle. Alors, si je veux avoir plusieurs extraits sur moi, je dois avoir d'abord trouvé plusieurs récipients vides. Exactement, mais pas n'importe lesquels. Les récipients à extrait vide, les récipients normaux peuvent corrompre les composants, voire même fondre. Vous êtes sûr que c'est pas dangereux de le boire? Ne vous en faites pas, votre corps ne risque rien. Quoi qu'il en soit, vous trouverez ces récipients aux quatre coins de la ville. Mes imbéciles de clients les jettent n'importe où. Si vous les ramassez pour les réutiliser, vous rendez service à la ville ainsi qu'à vous-même. Mieux en mieux. Bon, j'essaierai de voir si j'en trouve. Maintenant que cette question est réglée, j'aurai un petit service à vous demander, bien sûr. Vous savez, le chercheur dont je vous ai parlé, celui qui a le codex ancien, eh bien, nous avons étudié ces textes ensemble, mais nous sommes dans une impasse et il manque de nombreux matériaux rares pour continuer. Je compte les réunir moi-même, mais mon dos est à nouveau bloqué. Désolé d'abuser de votre gentillesse. Pourriez-vous dénicher les matériaux dont j'ai besoin? Ça ne devrait pas poser de problème, mais dites-moi, il n'existe pas des extraits pour le mal de dos? Effectivement, ce serait très utile, mais les extraits ne soignent pas les petits bobos du quotidien. Leurs effets sont principalement axés sur les situations obscures. Sans blague, vous êtes sûr que je pourrais trouver tous ces matériaux rares en ville? Ouais. Tous les extraits peuvent être fabriqués avec des choses que l'on trouve dans la rue. Évidemment, la vraie recette utilise des matériaux naturels, mais j'ai appris à trouver des substituts comme le bon rat des villes que je suis. Je vous préviens, certaines choses pourraient vous sembler un peu étranges, mais je vous assure qu'elles ont toutes une fonction spécifique. Une fois, il m'a envoyé chercher de la nourriture pour chat et du latex. J'aurais préféré oublier. Je vous donnerai de nouvelles recettes d'extrait pour vous dédommager. D'ailleurs, j'ai déjà un service à vous demander. Pourriez-vous m'apporter de l'armoise? De l'armoise, ouais, je m'en occupe. Ok, bon. Sorti. C'est bon, je suis ressorti. On va pouvoir reprendre notre quête principale.
To imagine. And you're saying Sawa-sensei was given this picture?
Right. And it must have really shaken her up. She wouldn't even stick around to have a chat. Some mysterious woman handed her the photo. She's gotta be linked to Hiro Mikoshiba's murder in one way or another. If I had to guess, she's working with or for Ehara. But I couldn't tell you how they're connected.
It might even be that she's the one who hired the Yokohama Liomong to attack you at that restaurant. If they're telling you to drop the Mikoshiba case, they're connected too.
A threat like that might have worked on a run-of-the-mill detective in over his head.
But how do you think you even got on their radar at all, Yagamishi? Mikoshiba's case is so big they needed hired muscle to stop you?
If I'm that much of a thorn in their side, the police investigation is worse.
Yeah, that's true. Even if they stop you in your tracks, Kanagawa police would just pick up the trail right where you left off.
I have to figure. I'm not the one they were really there to threaten into staying silent. It was Sawa-sensei. 4 years ago, when Toshiro Ehara killed himself, apparently, she thought Mikoshiba was the one bullying him. I set up that meeting with her so she could tell me more about what really happened at the time. But as of now, someone's pretty bent on making sure she doesn't reveal that. That'd be my guess.
Well, if that's the case, I'm afraid their threats were actually pretty effective. Sawa-sensei's lips are sealed now. There's not much we can really do about it.
Don't worry. I'm not near done yet. Besides, they've already made one big mistake.
Yeah?
They hired a gang thinking they could scare a detective off the scent. No way in hell they're expecting me to double down even harder on it.
You're totally right. That was a rather massive oversight on their part.
That night, the news broke on every channel and across the internet that the corpse found in Ichincho had been identified. Every student, teacher, and faculty member at Serio High School would know how Hiro Mikoshiba died. The details were heartbreaking, and a lot of lives were about to be turned upside down.